Howdy, folks. This is Kerry Kean checking in here from Isolationville, and I'm happy to be part of this Prineapalooza. Thanks to Charlie for inviting me. I'm going to do a John Prine song that I've been doing for a long time. In fact, the B string band, which I was a part of, recorded this song a few years ago at the GAR Hall. And I know Charlie said this has got to be live, but I'm going to cheat just a little bit and borrow the intro from that song. So hit it, maestro.
Please don't bury me.
Just like being in church.
Down in the cold, cold ground. Well, I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around.
Throw my brain in a hurricane, and the blind can have my eyes, and the deaf can take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. I woke up this morning, I put on my slippers, I walked into the kitchen and I, and oh, what a feeling when my soul went through that ceiling, and I loved you to heaven I did ride. When I got there, they did say it happened this way. You slipped on the floor and hit your head. Ow. All the angels say just before you passed away, these were the very last words that you said. Please don't bury me down in that cold, cold ground. No, I'd rather have them cut me up, pass the parts around. Throw my brain in a hurricane, the blind can have my eyes, and the deaf can take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. Well, get my stomach to Milwaukee if they run out of beer. Put my socks in a cedar box, just get them out of here. Ooh, Venus to Milo, have my arms. Look out, I've got your nose. Sell my soul to the junk man and give my love to Rose. But please don't bury me down in that cold, cold ground. Ooh, I'd rather have them cut me up, pass the parts around. Throw my brain in a hurricane, and the blind can have my eyes, and the deaf can take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. Well, give my feet to the footloose, the careless, fancy free. Give my knees to the needy, don't pull that stuff on me. Hand me down my walking cane, it's a sin to tell a lie. Send my mouth way down south and kiss my ass goodbye. But please don't bury me down in that cold, cold ground. Though I'd rather that they cut me up, pass me all around. Throw my brain in a hurricane, the blind can have my eyes, and the deaf can take both of my ears. I've been growing them now for a lot of years. The deaf can take both of my ears if they don't mind the size. Just keep it rolling, I guess. See if it'll make it through. So we're supposed to do a one John Prine song and one Prine-esque song, I guess you'd say. And so this is one that I wrote based on a drawing I did a long time ago, which I can't find anymore, which is aggravating. But of an angel and a demon having an argument in a tavern. And so this is called Angel and Demon. It's a kind of a talking blues story song, which John Prine loved to tell stories in his song, and so do I. So, Angel and Demon. Well, an angel and a demon met in a bar one night, but there wasn't no fussing and there wasn't no fight. Just a little arm wrestling, but it ended in a tie, and they both claimed later that they really didn't try. So they ordered up a beer and they sat down to talk about the price of the soul and whether bullshit could walk. But a wise man paused while fools rush in, and why an angel would even want to dance on a pin. They complained about their bosses and the hours that they worked, which cherubs were a pain, which devils were jerks. They talked about the weather up above and down below, and whether miracles were even worth what it took to make them go. Well, the conversation bounced around until it caught the ear of the woman tending the bar that night, who thought it rather queer. And the next round they ordered, she stood there and listened. Finally said, "Excuse me, boys, but there's something here I'm missing. I always thought the two of you were mortal enemies, yet here you sit like old friends exchanging pleasantries, as if you weren't soldiers in that heaven-well vacation, though war for mankind's soul, salvation or damnation." The angel sighed and took a drink, the demon shrugged his shoulders, they shared a glance, and they leaned in closer. "If you keep a secret, darling," the angel softly spoke, "we'll let you in on a little universal cosmic joke. Truth is, we're two sides of the same coin, you see, like the roots and branches of a heavenly tree. Each one needs the other, neither one can stand alone, and ever since you planted us, you can see how much we've grown." "Wait a minute," the barmaid cried, "how can that be true? I thought God created man, you say we created you." The demon laughed and shook his head. "You human beings," he cried, "you're the source of bad and good, we're just along for the ride." The angel finished his drink and the demon did the same. The barmaid said, "For all this evil then, who's to blame?" "When it comes to sin," the angel said, "we just point the way. But right or wrong, the choice is yours at the end of the day." The angel said, "It's time we left," they both turned away. The barmaid stood there in a daze, but finally thought to say, "Boys, for all those beers you drank, you owe me still." The demon murmured, "Put it on mankind's tab. That's who pays our bill." An angel and a demon at the bar one night. There wasn't no fussing, there wasn't no fight, just a friendly conversation over a couple of beers. We could all learn a lesson from that. So cheers. Thanks for listening, everybody. I plan to enjoy the rest of the Prineapalooza. Hope you do the same. Thanks, Charlie.